my path to being an artist was not necessarily a straight path. My early studies were in science. I got a bachelor's degree in microbiology, medical technology, first time around. I think for some viewers, there's a sense that somehow art and science are completely unrelated. But to me, I always felt that in a sense, science is about a kind of creative thinking. It involves visualization. It certainly involves imagination. I'm very interested in what I would consider to be the kind of world of models. And what I mean by that is I'm interested in architectural models, the way that it's a kind of visualization of something that's still in the imagination but is going to be made material at some point, but also the way models operate within the sort of language of science, how it's a way of trying to visualize or represent the unrepresentable. These pieces, although they are could be termed organic, they have complex curves, there's a geometry and there's a kind of order that's still in play. And I think that there's something very diagrammatic about these forms. It comes through in the fact that they operate sort of like drawings in space. The frame itself is made with a steel round bar or tubing, and it's actually hand-built. What I do in the studio is that I draw the shapes and work with those in a very direct manner. I mean, it's really just straightforward drawing. And then with helpers, take this steel bar and bend it to configure to those exact shapes, and then those are put together from 2D to 3D. Then it's covered with a screening that's a sort of a scrim-like, semi-transparent fabric, really. It's actually knitted, and it's made for outdoor applications. It comes from South Africa. I think it's almost participating with the light that's in the space. I feel like that this particular building is so much about light. These pieces by day are backlit in a way that they almost disappear. In the evening, when the night sky is the sort of backdrop for the pieces, they become much more opaque. I wanted to work with a sculpture that that moved through the space in a sense, that engaged the space both horizontally and vertically. What I worked with in terms of design was not just the forms within a cluster of the six clusters, but the way that those clusters were configured in the space to create areas of density and areas of lightness. Professors who would be working in the space came and had very positive things to say about the work, and to me, I was half teasing, but probably not teasing at all, when I said, well, you are really the people that I'm doing this for at the end of the day.